Hey, Dwarf Breath. So today I pretty much spent the entire day going to all the payday loans I could get. I was able to get my fiance another 3,000 in cash, but unfortunately, I've still not been able to get her the plane ticket that she's going to need so she can be safe, which is why I'm going to probably set up a GoFundMe tonight, because I'm in a little bit of trouble with the payday loans. I realize that I only have 2 weeks to pay those off, and it's a pretty significant penalty if you don't get it paid, and I'm a little bit worried about it at the moment. But that should be fine, because Miss Travinsky is going to pay me the rest of the money this weekend, so everything should be okay. But I'm still just a little bit worried about that. But I also wanted to comment on those videos that Daryl's been posting about me and all those people that he's been using as their crisis actors. I don't know any of those people. I've never met them in my life. But not Matthew. No, he's real. He's my cousin. And he's... I don't really know what to say about him, but that situation, it did occur a few summers ago. We were playing base softball. I clearly tagged him out at second base, and he refused to leave. He said that I did not tag him, that he was safe, and we had a dispute about this, and I eventually forced him off the field, and he immediately tried to get aggressive with me. I had no choice but to put him on the ground and put him in a hammerlock and subdue him until help arrived. But that's not what happened. No, he got up and he wanted to fight me, and it's fair dinkum. He wants to have fair fisticuffs with me. I obliged him. He said a number of very, very insulting things to me, so I agreed to engage him in fisticuffs, and I was the clear victor. I was able to overcome and subdue him very quickly. And I don't see what the issue was. His son was in the wrong. He was a parent. He should have done a better job teaching his son right from wrong. And he didn't have anything to say when it happened. He didn't say anything. So I don't know. Besides, in his family, it's his wife that wears the pants in his family. She's the muscle of Matthew in the pair. So I had to deal with her, but not him. And Matthew's saying that they agreed that they were never going to speak to me again. That's not true. That's not true. I don't talk to them because they're losers. He is a pathetic wimp. And Matthew, I'd say, I'm pretty sure that he's got to be 18 by now, and if he's got some sour feelings about our engagement or you, then you can meet me anytime. Because if you play with Bull, you get the horns. I don't care anyway. I've received a number of new, unbelievably beautiful pictures of my fiance, and I'm really happy with those. I'm going to stare at those while I go to sleep tonight. I like them apples.